co-producer of The Secret Garden. And my name is Nicole Bonsall, and I'm also a student co-producer of The Secret Garden. Thank you for coming to tonight's show. Before we start, we have a few announcements. Please turn your cell phones on silent or vibrate, or better yet, turn them off. Their frequencies can interfere with our microphones.
If you need to exit the theater during the performances for any reason, we ask that if possible, you wait until the scene changes or applause to exit and re-enter. There will be a brief 10-minute intermission during tonight's show.
Photo CDs of the play are being sold in the lobby. We have forms. Also, in the lobby after the show, you can buy flowers if you forgot to provide them for someone.
Please mark your calendars for our next drama club production. Fiddler on the Roof will be performed on April 25th through 27th. Please join us in the lobby after the show for our green room reception.
We'll have punch and cake, and it'll be directly after the show.
You'll be able to greet your cast and crew and enjoy lots of food.
Thanks for coming to tonight's show.
Martha, how many times have I told you not to run? Running inside a house is never attractive.
But it's a carriage.
I heard you the first
time. Imagine Mrs. Medlock coming all the way from India.
You talk too much, Martha.
Sorry, Mrs. Medlock. That's what my mom says. I talk too much.
Staff, I don't wish to repeat myself. Pay strict attention.
Yes, Mrs. Medlock.
As you know, a young lady is coming to stay here at Misselthwaite Manor. Mary Lennox. She has no one else in the world.
Poor child, her parents took up with cholera far off down in Tistis.
What is cholera?
You don't want to know that.
Yes, I do.
It's like a terrible fever, only worse.
Never mind that. She is to be left to herself, more or less. I understand she's a moody child. Above all, there is to be no mention of, well, you know who. Mr. Craven's orders. Dwell and stand.
Yes, Mrs. Medlock.
Good.
She's here! I'll get the door!
You'll do no such thing. Forget yourself, Martha.
Sorry, Mrs. Medlock.
John?
Yes, Mrs. Medlock?
The door.
Right you are. The door.
Mind your manners. Chin up. The rest of you can go back to your duties. There's more than enough work to keep you busy, I'm sure.
Mrs. Medlock, you are Mrs. Medlock.
I am. You're Mrs. Crawford?
Quite so. You have no idea how happy I am to be back in England.
There's no place like England.
My husband is in the Lancers. He's been reassigned.
It was most kind of you to escort Miss Lennox from India.
What choice did I have? The outbreak of cholera was devastating. People have no idea. She could have returned by herself. I should like to speak with Mr. Craven.
I'm afraid that's not possible. He's in poor health. Never receives.
How inconvenient. In any case, my duty is done. She's your worry now. This is Mary Lennon.
What? Her?
This is my servant.
Gunshi.
I never travel anywhere without Gunshi. I find her indispensable. I thought Mary was pretty Gunshi.
She must have slipped away.
Gracious! You have lost a child? Don't be absurd. She's with us when she came into the house. I know she's given a turn, Mrs. Medlock. At the gap, has been in a trial. She's seven.
Obstinate.
Contrary.
Willful.
Oh, you're that said with Moody.
She's that too. I've never seen the creature smile. The gal is bored beyond all reason.
I hope she won't protect them. I've no hand for tantrums and such. Every advantage I have goes to managing this large house. It's no easy task.
I'm sure. Better go see if you can find her, Conchi. She could have gotten far.
Yes, Mim Sati. Here she is now.
Where were you, Mary?
I wanted to look about. It's a gloomy sort of house, isn't it? I doubt if I should be happy here. Best not to get my hopes up.
She talks like a little old lady. Give yourself time, child. You'll soon make some friends.
I didn't think so. People never liked me, and I never like people. I never have any friends.
See what I mean?
Yes, I do. I do indeed. My word, she's a plain piece of goods. And I heard her mother was a great beauty. Didn't have much of a doubt. Seems thin to me. Too pious.
Perhaps she will improve as she grows older, like a late blooming flower.
There's nothing likely to improve children here at Mrs. Great Manor. She could do with a nice expression.
Go on! Talk about me as if I weren't here! Why should I care? After all, I'm only Mary Lennox, who might improve as she grows older.
Then again, she might not. Dear me, she doesn't hold a tongue, does she?
As I told you, Mrs. Medlock,
stubborn.
She's obstinate.
I've never seen such a contrary child.
She is as spoiled as they come.
The master will not put up with her willfulness.
I cannot imagine why her parents are to be so very rude and difficult.
I'm only a small innocent child. I just prefer to get my way.
I don't know how you'll be able to tame the likes of her.
Passing from India, I'd like to have lost my mind trying to figure out where she was and what she was doing.
I can well imagine. She'll have to comply with the rules of this house.
I will not!
She'll have to do as she is told.
I won't be bossed!
You'll have to be rather fair with this child.
I will get my way!
Well, I never.
More flavour than we do in England.
Miss Mary? She's not still sleeping, is she?
How should I know? I'll take that.
Which one of you is Sowerby?
We're all Sowerby, Miss Mary.
Martha Sowerby?
I'm Martha, Miss Mary. And this be Jane.
Miss Mary.
And this be Betty.
Miss Mary.
Mrs. Medlock said you were to look after me. You should have been here earlier. I hadn't dressed myself.
Had you put on your own clothes?
You're a strange sort of servant. I never had dressed myself in India. It's the custom. When I was in India, Conti dressed me.
That being the farm lady in the strange dress, the one who came with you in the carriage?
It's not a strange dress. It's called a sari. It's what Hindu women wear in India. You're very ignorant.
It's true. I'm to look after you, but I'm really not your servant.
Then whose servant are you?
She's Mrs. Medlock's servant, and Mrs. Medlock's Mr. Craven's servant.
Does my uncle know him here?
That he does, miss. But you needn't expect to see him, because since when you went.
He comes and goes as the moon strikes.
But I want to see him.
He rarely sees anyone.
But I'm his niece.
That's not like me, indifference to the master.
No, set in his way to you.
What is this stuff? Looks hot.
It's Indian porridge. Cook made a special feed.
I never eat porridge. Throw it out.
Throw it out? Oh, Miss Mary, you don't mean that.
I always mean what I say.
Put a spoon of sweet syrup on it. Or a bit of sugar. That'll make it tasty.
Didn't you hear what I said? I don't want it. I don't want any breakfast.
I hate to see good food go to waste.
If some children saw this tray, they'd look it clean.
What?
Why? Because they're as hungry as young hawks and foxes.
I don't know what it is to be hungry. Take it away.
The cocoa too?
I don't like cocoa.
But cook it in cinnamon.
Cinnamon only makes it worse. I hate cinnamon. Now, help me with my dress.
If you say so, miss.
What am I to do with myself all day?
Mrs. Medlock says you're not to make nuisance of yourself. You're in the house, twice a day out of the way.
It's such a large house. I'll go exploring.
Mrs. Medlock wouldn't like that. I think you're talking about.
How many rooms?
No one knows for certain. Over 600, they say. Most of them is locked up, though. Dickon is working in the gardens. He likes company.
Who's Dickon?
Me brother. You like him, Miss Mary. He knows all about making gardens bloom. And when it comes to animals, he's the best friend they got. Birds come and eat right out of his head. However, little there is to eat, he always eats a bit of his bread to coax his pet.
I doubt if I'll like him. I'm sure he won't like me.
I can't stand to chat to Miss Mary. I got me duties. Take a walk outside the house. Get to know the place. That's me advice. If you get hungry, cook will fix you something.
Martha!
Yes, miss?
I heard someone crying last night. I'm sure of it. Did you hear someone crying?
Goodness, miss, I never hear anything at night. I'm tucked in the attic.
I'm certain I heard someone crying.
If you say so.
I know what to do. I'll get my skipping rope.
That's a good idea, miss. Have yourself a little holiday.
Craven had spoken to me. You come as a complete surprise, Miss Wiggin. I'm not complaining. I think a governess and Miss Mary is an excellent idea. I can't turn to my duties and watch her as well. She's not an easy child to deal with. She's the sort of girl who gets on one's nerves. Books and lessons would do some good. The girl needs discipline.
I don't have to hear your problems, children.
I hope you do. However, the decision rests with the master. I shall bring up the matter when the moment seems right.
How did your garden grow?
That's Miss Mary Lock.
Silver bells and corkle shells and marigolds all in a row. Mistress Mary. Mistress Mary, quite...
We don't skip rope inside the house, Miss Mary. It's unattractive.
I don't see the difference it makes. I'm no good at it inside and out. Mrs. Crawford gave a skipping rope to me on shipboard. She said exercise would do me good. Nobody skips rope in India. It just isn't done. Who are you?
This is Miss Wiggin. Young Dr. Craven suggested her for the position of governess.
Who's Dr. Craven?
Bless me. You seem to know very little, Miss Mary. He's your uncle's cousin.
You don't mean a governess for me?
Who else, I should like to know?
I don't need a governess. I don't want a governess. I'm quite intelligent for my age. No, 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 no governess! I don't have one! Mistress Mary, quite contrary, how does your garden grow? With silver bells and cockle shells and merry corn and bread.
What did I tell you?
I'll say this for her. She
hasn't
had
it.
More
pity. Now what?
The child is eating breakfast. Having every special
cheese. She's either not having a proper breakfast.
She said she hates porridge.
Hates cocoa too.
She can't avoid cinnamon. I won't be held responsible for the last he goes to skin and bones.
The governess is definitely culpable.
Quite.
Since she's been at Misselthwaite Manor, I'm quite sure before that too.
You don't get that obstinate overnight.
Oh, contrary,
I think she must be the most obnoxious child I've ever seen.
I don't think she's eaten enough to keep a bird alive. Absolutely refuses.
Says she eats everything, even sweets.
And she won't come there if she's thought either.
That you do, ma'am. That you do.
Mary, what are you doing?
Robin. I know you're chirping. What's wrong with your back, you? Does it feel as good to see another book, eh? Well, I won't disappoint you. Let's see. How about I plant some Johnny Jump-Ups and some violets and some coral bells? Maybe some sweet fern.
Who are you talking with, Diggin?
Dr. Graven. He's up there. Follows me about straight around.
See him. You mean that Robin Redbreast?
Aye. He's smart on that little bird. He likes to chatter.
I'll take your word for it. No doubt you understand his peculiar language. You certainly have a way with creatures on the field.
But this is a gift. You've been sealed by one star.
Yes, I'm pleased with his progress. His broken leg is on the mend. However, I don't want him up and about, and he's worried about the grounds. He wants to come down here.
Got nothing to fear. Got everything under control. Gloves.
I'm sure you do.
What is this golden bed? Try to him off. Excellent idea. Reassure all's well. That's the best medicine. Leave it to me. Good lad. What's that?
What
do you say?
What do you
say? 101,
102, 103.
Come on, miss.
I know who you are. Dickens
Salvey.
Martha's brother?
Yes.
You know all about flowers and animals. Martha said so.
I do know a lot. And I'm ashamed to admit that.
Aren't you kind of young to be the head gardener?
I'm not the head gardener. I help out a few days a week. I mean, it's every day and I have all of them on the staff and later before the break. Me as young as I'd like to be.
I'm Mary Lennox.
I know, miss. I'm all the way from India. I reckon you met all kinds of strange animals and such. I envy you.
What doesn't meet animals? They're just there. I suppose you mean the animals in India. Elephants and the like.
I've never seen an elephant, except in the picture box.
They can be disagreeable, especially if they have a bad tooth.
Dickon! When you have a moment, would you come and have a look at the new pony? He don't seem lively enough to me. He's off his feet, too!
I'll be to the stable, since so a visit with old Ben. This will be my sister with us. She's a stable hand.
Miss Mary?
Seems to me there are a lot of salaries for Mrs. Wayne Mack.
We're a large family.
Aye.
Dickon! Dickon!
It's Mother! Let's get the others. She won't want to see us all.
I will! Dickon!
Hold on, Mrs. Black. Mrs. Wayne Mack. I reckon my salaries will go to bed hungry many a night.
I'm hungry now. I didn't have any breakfast.
There was something in the basket. You'll see.
You seem pleasant enough. Maybe we could be friends, but it's doubtful. I don't have any friends.
There you are, Dickon. Did you hear me calling?
I'll speak with Miss Mary.
The young lady all the way from India? How nice. Welcome to Yorkshire, child. Please give me regards to your dear uncle.
She didn't have any breakfast.
No breakfast? The poor thing. Mustn't go without eating. Doesn't do. I bought some delicious apples that Ben said I might pick, and some cinnamon buns to bake this morning for Dickon and his brothers and sisters. They were raised on them.
I don't like cinnamon, but maybe an apple.
An apple it is. You're my pale, Miss Mary. You could do with a bit more colour in your cheeks.
Why does one section of the garden have a wall around it?
You mean over there?
Yes. Couldn't find a door.
There's a locked door here somewhere, but no one's seen it in over 10 years. Shelves of vines have covered it up. Ben will know where it is.
Well, if there's a locked door, there must be a key.
You must have buried the key when it closed the garden. Said no one was ever going there again.
What?
Gracious child! Didn't your uncle tell you?
I haven't seen my uncle. I suspect he's not too happy up here. Why did he bury the key to the garden? Tell me.
I suppose you have a right to know. There's a terrible accident. The garden was your aunt's favorite spot. She tended it all by herself. Roses, mostly. She was just a bit of a girl. There's an old tree with a branch but like a seat on it. One day when she was sitting there, the branch broke. She fell to the ground. Hurt so bad the next day she died. The doctor thought Mr. Cravenwell's mind died too, but he didn't. That's why he hates that wild garden and won't ever let anyone go in there. He loved her, Lilius, so.
Lilius?
That was your aunt's name. The son says she only married Archibald Craven because he was rich, him with crippled Barker. But I think they loved each other dearly. Now it is letting you travel here and there to forget. Go on, man.
Very lonely here.
I don't see how you can say that, Miss Mary. You haven't been here long.
Doesn't matter. I'm lonely no matter where I am. I expect I always will be.
Goodness, child. That's no way to look at things.
Mother!
Mother! It's Jane and Betty.
Mother!
It's Martha!
What's in the basket? Cinnamon buns, I wager?
Let's all have one.
Better not let Miss Medlock catch us.
Leave the apples. I'll take them back home with me.
I'll make some tasty pies.
Let me stop by to visit with old Ben. Poor Carter. A broken leg is no blessing. But I couldn't leave without saying hello.
You mean to say all these servants are your children, Mrs. Salvey?
They're only children, yes. Of course, the glory of Mr. Sam, too. May he rest in heaven.
How curious. And I suppose I shall spend my days here, wandering about, being lonely and bored.
Rubbish, child. I know. You must get yourself a bit of ground in your garden. It will do wonders for you.
You won't know me then.
You'll see. I don't know anything about gardens.
Let Dickon be your teacher, miss.
He could be like a brother to you. I never had any brothers. Or sisters.
I've got seven.
I know what we'll do, Miss Mary. That is, if you like. I don't mean to presume.
What?
We'll make you an honorary member of the Salvey family.
It's most certainly a curious proposition. Yes, I think I might like it. Thank you.
Welcome to the family, Miss Mary.
There are so many in your family. How does it work?
Oh, Mary, a family is a sacred thing. It's something to cherish.
We all work together to make sure that things get done.
Like the cooking and the cleaning.
Laughing and playing.
We're one big happy family. We love each other and we take care of each other. Can you understand that?
I've got lots of people to take care of me. They didn't make me happy.
That's because they're not your family.
My family's...
Oh, Mary, we didn't mean to upset you. There's so many of us, yet we always have room in our hearts for one more.
Yeah, of course we do.
Family is people that care about you. Really care about each other.
I don't quite know what to say.
So you'll be a sister?
I'll be a sister.
No will to get well, one does not.
How perceptive.
To bring one down and only magnify the situation.
If you say so, nurse.
I have my orders. I do as I am told.
You know your place as I do. Ask not to question.
From time to time, I have made suggestions to young Dr. Craven about treatment, but they fall on deaf ears. I've learned to hold my tongue.
Wise.
If only the boy wouldn't cry so much. In that temper.
I believe that's because he's unhappy.
And spoiled. The boy is terribly spoiled. I've said enough. Perhaps too much.
I would never betray confidence.
Thank you, Mrs. Medlock.
You're welcome, I'm sure.
He wanted to see me, Mrs. Medlock.
Ah, Miss Mary, it's your uncle. He wants to see you before he leaves.
He's going somewhere.
Isn't he always? Travel to foreign places. Somehow it doesn't seem natural.
Shall I go and brush my hair?
Put on my best dress. There isn't time. He wishes to see you at once. He'll be gone within the hour. That's how he is. Come along.
What will I say to him?
How should I know?
What if he doesn't like me?
That's your affair.
Sir?
Mr. Craven?
Yes, who is it?
This is Miss Mary, sir.
Ah. You can get in, Mrs. Medlock. Wait outside. I'll call when I want you to take her away.
Very good, sir.
Step closer, child. Are you well?
Yes.
I will be gone for some time. You'll be left here in rooms. Consequently, I'm thinking of employing a governess for you.
Don't make me have a governess!
That's what Mrs. Sowerby said. She's quite fond of you. Do you like Mrs. Sowerby?
Yes, I do. Very much.
She knows about young people. She has 8 of her own. Many of them are in service here at Misselthwaite Manor.
I know.
She thought you should get stronger before you have a governess. Seems to think you don't eat enough. Are you afraid of me?
I'm generally not afraid of people I never get to see.
Well, I suppose you've heard I'm a hunchback. I'm not. My back isn't very straight, that's all. I fear I know nothing of children. Legally, I am your guardian, but I'm a poor one for any child. I can give you neither time nor attention, until ill, wretched, and distracted. I sent for you today because Mrs. Sowerby said I ought to see you. I'm fond of Mrs. Sowerby. She's kind and respectable. I listen to her advice. I don't know when I will see you again, if ever, but I do wish you to be happy and comfortable. Play out the doors as often as you can. Mrs. Sowerby said it ought to do you good. Do you want toys, books, dolls?
Might I have...
Speak up, child. What is it you want?
Might I have a bit of earth?
Earth? What do you mean?
To plant seeds in. To watch things grow. To make things come alive.
No doubt you've been talking to that boy Dicker. A bit of earth. You may have as much earth as you want.
Is there something wrong, Uncle? The way you're staring at me.
You remind me of someone else who loved earth and things that grow. When you see a bit of it you want, take it, child. Make it come alive for you.
Maybe take it from anywhere, if it's not wanted.
Why not? Take it from anywhere, if that is your wish. There's a county fair in the village next week. You might like that. I haven't been in over years. I used to enjoy it. Mrs. Sowerby asked that I give you permission to visit a cottage whenever you wish. I gave my consent.
Thank you, sir.
Mrs. Sowerby and Mrs. Medlock went to school together a long time ago. Mrs. Medlock?
Sir?
Now that I have seen the child, I agree with Mrs. Sowerby.
You mean she's not to have governess?
Not yet, anyway. Give her simple, healthy food. Don't look after her too much. She needs liberty, fresh air, and romping about.
Uncle said I might have a garden.
Fine by me, I'm sure. It'll keep you out of the house.
Goodbye, Mary Lennox.
He really is a nice man,
if you say so. Come on now, Miss Mary. You heard the master. You're to look after yourself now. But you know the rules. You're on side. Don't go wandering and poking about. It's unattractive.
I heard someone crying again last night.
Don't talk rubbish.
Oh, Martha! Wait till you hear.
You seem happy enough, Miss Mary.
I just met my uncle.
Good for you, miss. I was afraid he'd leave without as much as saying hello to you.
He says I can do whatever I want. And I can have my garden!
Dickon will be a big help there.
I can visit your mother's cottage whenever I wish!
Mother will be pleased. She's taking a real liking to you. Says you need a bit of mothering.
I heard it again last time.
What?
Mrs. Medlock said I was talking rubbish. I know what I heard. And I know where it's coming.
You don't mean crying, do you?
Of course!
Oh, Miss Mary, don't go poking about. It would only upset things.
Who is it that cries? You know. Don't you?
Is. I know. But I can't talk about it. None of us can. It's one of the master's rules. I could lose my position. Now, please, don't ask any more questions.
Why didn't you
I don't want it. I won't take it. No, no, no!
But Master Colin, you must!
No, no, no!
Now look what you've done!
Serves you right. It's all your fault.
Your medicine all over the floor. I intend to tell Dr. Craven about this.
Tell him anything you like. What do I care?
You know you're not supposed to excite yourself.
Then stop giving me medicine I don't want. You're supposed to humour me. You're supposed to do everything I say.
Get back into bed, Master Colin.
I wish to be left alone.
At once.
No, no, no! Get up, get up, get out!
Please, Master Colin.
I'll scream until I wake the whole household. You know I'm capable of that.
Very well. Calm down. Don't get excited. I'm leaving.
Good. Who are you? Are you a ghost?
No, I am not.
I'm Colin Craven.
I'm Mary Lennox. Mr. Craven is my uncle.
He's my father. I suppose we're cousins then.
Suppose you must be. Mr. Savvy told me that you and me this afternoon. You're a great mystery. If it weren't for Mr. Savvy, I'd know little about this white man.
My father won't let people talk about me. The servants are forbidden to.
Why?
If I live, I may be a hunchback instead of just an invalid. My father hates to think I may be like him.
Is that why I hear you crying?
Yes. I cry because it makes father wretched to look at me. Are you sure you're not a ghost?
I want to know whether I'm a ghost or not.
My dreams are very real. Sometimes when I open my eyes, I don't believe I'm awake.
I'll prove it to you.
Ow!
See? You're awake.
I don't allow anyone to touch me, except the doctor. How dare you do such a thing?
There's no need to be unpleasant.
Don't pinch me again. Are you here on a visit?
I live here. My parents died in India. There was an outbreak of cholera.
No one told me a word about it. Do you miss your parents?
I can't remember much about them. Servants raised me. Father was always away on military leave. Mother spent most of her time getting ready to attend parties. She is a great beauty, but I'm nothing like her.
You must come and visit me every day and tell me all about India. I have books to read, of course, but I get bored with books. When you were in India, did you ever step on a cobra?
I should say not! Have you only been here?
Yes. I used to wear an iron brace to keep my back straight. But then a specialist came from London and told my father to take it off. It was stupid, he said. He said I was to stay out in the fresh air as much as possible. I hate fresh air. I hate the sunshine. I bet you don't know how old I am.
10.
How do you know that?
Mrs. Savvy told me when you were born. The garden door was locked and the key was buried. And Dickon told me it's been locked for 10 years.
What garden door was locked? Who did it? Where was the key buried?
Your father hates that garden. He's the one who locked the door and buried the key.
You do know that, because I'm going to die. Everyone is obliged to please me. I want to know more about this garden. You must tell me.
I intend to reclaim that garden. Your father said I might have any bit of earth I wanted. Do you really think you won't live?
I've heard people say I won't.
Well, do you want to live?
No, but I don't want to die. When I feel ill, I lie in bed and think about it until I cry and cry. My doctor is my father's cousin. He's quite poor, and if I die, he will have all of Mrs. Wright when my father passes on. I should think he wouldn't want me to live. I want to know more about this garden. I want the key dug up. I want the door locked. I can go there in my chair. That would be getting fresh air. I'm going to make them open the door.
No!
Why not?
Because I want it to be a secret garden. You see, if no one knows but ourselves, it would be so much nicer. It would be special. If the garden was a secret, we could get into it. to it and watch the flowers grow bigger every day. No one would ever know we were there.
I've never had a real secret before, except that one about not living to grow up. They don't think I know, so it's sort of a secret. But I like this kind better. You and I will be the only ones to know about the garden.
Dickon will have to know. But I'm sure he's good at keeping a secret.
The boy who works for Ben Weatherstaff?
He is a wonderful gardener. He has a way with animals and birds. He can talk to them. The garden will be a lot of hard work. We'll have a great deal to learn. There is one problem, though.
What?
We'll have to find the key. It's all a bit easy now. It's somewhere behind the overgrown vines.
What is the meaning of this master calling? Nurse tells me he threw medicine all over the floor and refused to get into bed.
Get out, get out! I don't want you here! Can't you see I'm a visitor?
How did you get in here? Young lady, this is hardly the hour of visiting. Master Cord is unwell. I must ask you to leave.
No, no, no! I want Mary to stay!
That's out of the question. Nurse, see that he gets into bed. I'll prepare a sedative.
Yes, Doctor.
No, no, no! I don't want to sleep! I want Mary to stay! Ah!
He certainly has a temper.
I hope you're satisfied, miss.
I meant no harm!
I must ask you to stay out of these rooms in the future. Understand?
This is the most curious house I've ever been in.
Especially beautiful. No, he's one of my favorite plants.
He's
Perhaps I'd move let's take gloves to the bed.
Gloves to the bed, gloves to the bed. How about you, sir?
No, thank you.
Mum? Take flowers to the fair. Ladies, around the fair up there. Put a flower on your hair. How about you, Mum? Take flowers to the fair. Take flowers to the fair. Mum, don't look quite like a new hat. Take flowers to the fair.
No, thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget to mention that these flowers are absolutely free. The girl seems to work some magic on Master Colin.
His temper tantrums aren't nearly as wicked as they were. His breathing seems better.
There's always danger of relapse. We must never forget Master Colin has been through a lot. There's weak legs, rheumatic fever, coughs and colds that nearly killed him, even a touch of typhoid.
He seems less lonely. He hasn't cried in weeks.
I get quite tired telling you stories about India. Besides, I must neglect the god.
You have a god, Miss Mary.
Not really a god. You couldn't call it that. A piece of earth. That's what it is. My uncle said I might have it.
When was that?
Some months ago, before we went abroad.
And what do you have in a piece of earth?
Only the things that Dickens Sound recommends.
Good lad, then, Dickon.
Things are starting to grow. There are clusters of purple crocuses and gold ones. Leaves are starting to break out and uncurl.
It's the season.
Plan to visit that piece of earth soon.
No, Master Colin. I'm impressed by improvement, but we mustn't rush things. Our returns. I'm a. That leg's not as good as I thought. May have to go to the hospital. Keep up with the medication, nurse.
Yes, doctor.
Does Dr. Craven ever smile? Is that a funny question?
No, miss. But that's what folks asked about you when you first came to Mrs. Y Manor. Does Miss Mary ever smile?
I suppose I have changed a great deal. Still, it's nothing to laugh about.
I wanted you to stay with me all afternoon.
You're being silly. I have too many things to attend to. Besides, I must visit with Ben.
You have to do what I say. Everybody does.
That again? You're like a young Rajah in India, sitting on a silken pillow and always wanting his own way. Well, I won't give in to you this time. I won't stay.
You will.
I won't.
Will.
Won't.
If you don't stay with me, I'll work myself into a tantrum.
Get away! You're so spoiled!
How dare you speak to me like that? How dare you?
I'm going to the garden, leaving you here!
If you go without me, I'll scream and yell!
See, no, I can! Besides, I can scream and yell louder than you!
You can't!
I can't!
Can't!
Can! There! How do you like it? Now, what's all this? Things were going so well between you two. Hysterics again? My, my. I'm going to be ordered about my collar. I'm his friend. What a servant.
She's cruel now, that's what she is. Cruel.
Say so to the young Raja.
Ow!
Now what?
I felt a lump on my back. It's growing.
You didn't feel a lump. You only want attention. And if you did feel a lump, it was only a hysteric lump. Hysteria causes lumps. There's nothing the matter with your back.
There is!
Nurse, show me his back this minute!
Perhaps he won't let me.
Go on, show her. She'll see then. She'll be sorry. She'll apologize. Satisfied?
There's not a single lump there. There's not a lump as big as a pig! Except backbone lumps. And you can only feel those because you're thin. I've got backbone lumps too. I'll be gone when I'm fatter. Same with you.
I didn't know he thought he had a lump on his spine. His back is weak only because he won't exercise and spends most of his time in bed. I could have told him there was no lump.
Do you think I could live to grow up?
You probably will if you do what you're told and not give way to your temper. Remember what the specialist from London said? Stay out a great deal in the fresh air.
Mary?
Yes, Raja?
Now, Miss Mary, be nice.
I'd like to be outside with you and digging.
Digging for the baby fox. And the crows come to visit.
Plenty of time for that later. Master Colin must rest. I'll fluff the pillows.
Oh, Mary, I thought you were going to give our secret away to Dr. Craven.
Never. It's our secret.
Tell me more about the garden.
It was left alone for so long that the roses climbed and climbed and climbed until they hung over the branches and the walls and crept over the grass.
Since I was in the vicinity, I thought I might as well stop by to have a word or two with Archibald Craven. I heard he was back.
Back in England, you mean?
Yes, London.
He stays at the Empress Hotel, a fashionable place. Not that Mr. Craven will notice. I suppose he's sitting in some large chair in the lobby, surrounded by gloom and doom.
You say he expressly stated Miss Mary was not to have a governess?
For the time being. I must say, the child has improved. She no longer sorts and pats. The last time I saw her, I thought she looked pretty, like a wildflower. Mrs. Salvia, a neighbor woman, attributes it to garden work.
Garden work?
You know, planting, weeding, and picking away the bugs.
Mary gave me these.
Aren't they choice?
Beautiful. Is Dr. Craven about?
Of course. He rarely leaves the state.
If the position of governess is not available at this time, I might as well look elsewhere. I've already spent too much of my time thinking about Misselthwaite Manor. You might tell Mr. Craven that a wildflower is very frequently mistaken for a weed.
That I will.
Nice bit of some deeds, some good Master Colin. It's nice to see you out and about.
You sound like my daughter.
Dr. Craven?
Miss Mary's my daughter.
Shall I try to find her?
She must be somewhere about.
No, she knows I'll be waiting here. Same as yesterday. I don't need you.
I think John and I ought to stay, sir.
I don't want you to stay. Understand? I want you to go back to the house. When it's time for me to return, Dickie and Mary will help me.
Very good, sir.
Mustn't catch a chill. The sun can fool you. How's that? Comfy?
Off you go.
Hello to you too, Mr. Robin. Fine day.
We left for you a little while ago.
Nurse made me take a bowl of hot soup. Said I couldn't go out, but I did.
Who pushed you up here?
Your brother, the footman.
John.
And your sister, Betty. I sent them back. I don't want to take any chances. No one must know about our secret.
Come along then, Colin. It's a lot of work. Every day, new day.
Let's see how the things we planted yesterday are coming along.
Things can't go that fast, Mr. Colin. Not even when you want them to.
Even I knew that.
Help me.
Is he does it?
That was better than yesterday.
You've been practicing them back exercises as you eat.
Yes, but I never tell the doctor. He might not approve.
I've got 6 packets of new seed. Bought with my own money. Plant them today.
I never knew the outdoors could be so much fun.
So much nicer than staying in your stuffy room.
Mary. Dickie.
What now?
I'd like to show you something. I haven't looked at it in a long, long time. I didn't want to.
The Cameo Bridge. I've never seen one so lovely. Look, Dickie.
Ah, it's open for sure. There's a beautiful lady here tonight.
My mother. I don't want to be reminded of her because she died and left me alone.
Are you still angry with her?
No. But I wish I could have known her. I wish she could have known me. I'd like to think she's looking down from heaven and seeing her son here in the secret garden.
I imagine she is.
Smiling because every day you're getting stronger and stronger.
You've got to believe in things real hard, Colin. If you believe hard enough, sometimes they come true. It's a kind of magic.
The thinking flowers is kind of fair for luck. But you've got to believe, otherwise it doesn't work.
Here are the seeds.
It's a beautiful day.
Aye.
Mistress Mary, quite the fair, how is your garden bed?
The silver bells and cockle shells and miracles all in a row.
Nurse, why is Master Cole not in his room?
I believe he's up and about. Doctor, I believe he'll be just fine. Do you want to come out for some fresh air?
He can't all of a sudden be up and about like this. We can't be taking any risks with the boy's health.
Master Colin seems to be improving. You said so yourself.
Yes, and I also said we mustn't rush things. Please see that he gets his rest.
Yes.
I don't understand it myself, but I must admit it's something of a miracle.
Why, just yesterday, Colin managed to make a joke. He even chuckled at himself.
I stayed by his bedside this morning. He slapped me on the derriere.
Master Colin does have a bit of colour in his cheeks and a bit of nerve as well, I hear.
Who would have thought it? Master Colin, alive and mood.
I've even seen him smile once or twice. I give a lot of the credit to Miss Mary. She doesn't spoil him or tolerate his standards, and she's quite wrong.
I haven't heard him scream or yell in weeks.
He doesn't throw his tantrums anymore. He's actually quite polite. He answers me when I speak.
Down by the stables, I saw him feed a carrot to a pony.
He never. Come to think of it, he's been eating much better himself.
When I lifted him out of his bed and put him in his chair, until I gain a pound or two.
He doesn't seem as tired or angry.
All I know is that something is happening to Master Colin. I wonder what could be the sudden cure.
You know what I'd like to be when I'm fully grown?
Master, what's your thought about it?
Besides that, I mean.
What?
A scientist. I intend to be a scientist. I intend to be the greatest scientist the world has ever known.
I expect I'll be right here, doing what I'm doing now. I should pay more attention to the vegetables. Cabbages and potatoes and carrots.
Why? Flowers are so much nicer to look at.
That's true, but most people don't want to eat flowers. English people, anyway.
Wouldn't my father be so surprised if he knew I was out here feeling ever so much stronger?
You could have Dr. Craven right away.
No, no. I don't want anyone to tell my father. I want it to come as a surprise.
We're still early enough. Marry me, we'll show you where the hedgehogs are living. Move around quite a bit,
Ned. I've never seen a hedgehog before.
They'll smile when you see them. Funny little creatures they are.
I never thought I'd live to see the day.
Hi, Mother.
Master Colin! Do you remember me then?
Of course I do, Mrs. Salvey. I met you a few years ago when I was still feeling strong enough to go to the fair. I didn't like it there. People stared at me. It was because of my chair.
I can hardly believe the eyes.
Mary, this was our secret. Yours and Higgins and mine.
But Mrs. Savvy is different. She's one of us. You don't really mind, do you?
I guess not. Seeing as how she's Higgins' mother and you told me so many wonderful things about her.
Hey, you'd be surprised.
Seeing Master Colin like this is more wonderful than any surprise I could have imagined. And this garden has come back to life. It used to be such a happy place. Oh, the memories. Oh!
What's wrong, Mrs. Abbey?
I know why the garden's come back to life. Your mother is in this garden. I can feel it. She's here. She couldn't keep out of it.
Well, if she's here, she'll like this. Here's the real surprise, Mrs. Abbey.
Her?
Well, Mr. Colin, show me Mother.
Show me what?
Mercy,
she can help the boy!
No, Mother, he's got to help himself.
Mr. Colin! Careful! Don't fall!
Go on, Colin. Walk.
What did you say, girl? Walk?
Just one small step. I know that you can do it.
Just one small step?
And then you'll be free of the chair. Free to run and play.
I can do it.
Come on, Colin. I know you can.
Watch me, I can do it.
Don't be fair, Dublin. Everybody does.
You can do it.
I can do it.
Tomorrow, Mrs. Crawford.
Are you to send it to the hotel where you're going to pick it up?
I I told them to deliver a dear message.
Mr. Archibald Craven of Mrs.
Wynanna,
Yorkshire.
Did you hear that, Conchie?
Mr. Craven? Mr.
Archibald
Craven?
Here, miss.
Mr. Craven?
One moment.
Thank you, sir. You see that, Conchie? Did you look at his letter?
He seems tired.
From what I've heard, he's perpetually tired. A listless dull man, terribly depressed. Now that I've seen him, I'm quite glad he wasn't that little white man when he came from India with that forcible Mara Lennox.
He does seem sad.
Never got over his worst death, I hear. Can't bear to be with his son because of the miles in the herd. I suspect he's a brute. Men like that usually are.
Perhaps you should introduce yourself?
Not likely. Wouldn't pay to know such a gloomy man. If he wishes to be unhappy, let him be.
So, Steve, he might be dreaming.
Dream on, Mr. Craven. Come on, Conchie. Got more important things to think about. Time for tea.
Yes, Mrs. Cromer.
There's a secret garden that's always in bloom. There are memories and miracles in the secret garden of mine. Archie!
Come to the garden, Archie. Feel the sun. Look at the roses. Please, come to the garden. It's been a long time since you've been here.
I miss you. Those rose trees were planted long ago. They're growing again. Remember how we were afraid they might be stunted? That family of robins, how they chatter and chirp? Our garden is a wonderful garden, isn't it?
We're always so
happy here. You mustn't be sad.
Lilius?
Of course, dear. It's Lilius. I'm here. I'm always close. Where would you expect me to be?
Where? Where?
In the garden, Archie. I'm in the garden. Our garden.
Lilius! Asleep. I was dreaming. Yes, that's it. I was dreaming. A letter. Mrs. Susan Sowerby. How odd.
Dear sir, I trust you will not think me forward, but I hope you've been kind to me in my past. I feel I can take the liberty. You will recall, sir, we once talked about young Miss Mary and how a governess might not be needed. She has come along so nicely, she has. But, sir, please, sir, I'd come home if I was you. I think you'd be glad to come, and if you'll excuse me, sir, I think a lovely young wife would ask you to come if she was here. Your obedient servant, Susan Sowerby.
Is this part of the dream too? Am I still dreaming? I'll go back to Miss Hawthorne. I'll find the key. I'll open the garden. I'll go at once.
Still eating free.
Are you sure it's a house, Kedge?
I am. And it was my uncle who got out.
This will be a surprise to Colin.
It was your mother who wrote.
Out of the goodness of her heart, you can be sure.
I hope this won't anger Colin.
We'll have to wait and see.
What's wrong with this, Archie? You seem possessed.
Call it what you will. What are you two doing here? Who opened the garden? Who found the key? Who dared?
I did, Uncle. You said I might have a piece of earth. Make it come alive for me.
I never dreamed you'd pick this place.
How did you find the key?
Oh, Robin showed me where it was buried.
Oh, Robin?
Fanciful, I'd say.
Oh, no, sir. There's general magic here. Feel it all the time.
I'm going back to the house. I wish to see my son.
There's no need to go back to the house for that, sir.
How's that?
See for yourself.
Who? What? Who? This is more of a dream.
Colin, where's your wheelchair?
It's him, sir. It's your son. It's why I wanted you to come home. A boy needs his father.
It's Master Colin, no doubt.
Can it be? You look so different out of the wheelchair.
I'm Colin. You can believe it, Father.
So strong, so tall. You look so much like your mother.
It's the garden that did it. And Marianne Dickin.
Well, you tend a rose, sir. A thistle cannot grow.
Oh, Colin, all these years I've forgotten how to live, how to love.
Don't be first stumbling, sir. Everybody else.
You've got a lifetime left to give to your son.
Can you ever forgive me, son?
I forgive you, Father.
I won't hide myself away in that dingy flat in London any longer. My days of running away are over.
You mustn't be too hasty, Archibald. I'll need to give Colin a thorough examination to determine whether this alleged recovery is real or merely a case of rallying before rapid decline.
Cousin, you've done enough already. I believe your services as a physician are no longer required. And since I'll be home to run the estate from now on, may I suggest you move to London and take up residence in my old flat there?
But...
I insist.
Very well.
As for you, son, we're gonna get together, shall we?
We'll always be.
Together. We'll always be together. Come back to the house with me, son. I want to know everything.
I guess the garden doesn't have to be a secret anymore.
Cousin... Be a good fellow and fetch the wheelchair back to the house, would you? I'm going to take a stroll with my son.
I'm never getting into that chair again. We'll walk to the house, Father. Together.
I'll fetch your chair for you. Keep stuck.
Whoops.
Don't count on it.
Ever so fine in this secret garden.